Come journey with us, walk with us, listen to our story. Our hopes, our dreams, our struggles, our joys, our story of life we share with you as we journey.
Friends, today let us reflect on the Gospel of Luke, chapter 24, verses 13 to 35. The incident in today's Gospel was composed by Saint Luke in such a way that we think about the Eucharist. By the time the Gospel came to be written, the expression, the breaking of bread, had become a Christian term to signify the Eucharistic celebration.
What manner of communications are these that ye have one to another? As ye walk and us sat.
Art thou only a stranger in Jerusalem and hast not known of the things which are come to pass there in these days?
What things?
Concerning Jesus of Nazareth, which was a prophet mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, and how the chief priests and our rulers delivered him up to be condemned to death and have crucified him. But we trusted that it had been he which should have redeemed Israel. And beside all this, today is the third day since these things were done. Yea, and certain women also of our company made us astonished, which were early at the sepulchre. When they found not his body, they came saying that they had also seen a vision of angels, which said that he was alive. And certain of them which were with us went to the sepulchre and found it even so as the women had said, but him they saw not.
O fools, and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Ought not Christ to have suffered these things, and to enter into his glory?
Abide with us, for it is toward evening, and the day is far spent.
Our Father, we offer thanks for thy bounties. Amen.
Amen. Did not our heart burn within us while he talked with us by the way, and while he opened to us the scriptures?
We must return to Jerusalem this very hour.
More importantly, at Mass, much the same thing happens to us as it happened to the two disciples on their journey to Emmaus. Jesus proclaimed to the disciples on the road what the scripture had to say. Then he explained its meaning. In the breaking of the bread, he not only shared a meal with them, but also revealed himself. My dear friends, even at Mass, at every Eucharist, every day we hear the scripture and explained in the sermon or homily. And in our breaking the bread, Jesus presents himself to us as the one who has passed through death to glory. In the Mass, we come to know Jesus in two ways. First, through the words of the scripture, that is the word of God. He enters our minds. And secondly, through the Eucharist, he enters our hearts. We come to know him. To know someone according to the scripture means to enter into intimate union. Jesus, my dear friends, wants to grow in our intimacy with him through the Eucharist.
Come journey with us, stay with us, make us one with you. In the blessing of bread, the breaking